Hey, this is René, and in this video I want to show you a program that I've wrote and that I want to give to you for free. This program is a trading journal, which is called TradeBuddy, and it helps you to have a good overview over all your strategies and over your trading in general. So you know what strategy is currently profitable and what strategy should maybe be turned off. So this program is not a new program, because I used I've wrote this TradeBuddy several years ago, and I always I already published it for the German speaking community. So it is already proven and many people use it already. But now I implemented a language function, so you can choose the English language to work with this program, even if you do not speak German. So first of all, I will show you how to get this program. You will find a link to the website or to this specific web page below this video, and if you click on it, you can find here this form on the right side where you can enter your email address. And once you did this, you will be the email address will be stored, because if there are any updates or anything with this TradeBuddy or any of our products, you will receive information via mail. So it is important to fill in an email that you check frequently. So if you filled in this email here, you can click on download, and you will then receive an email where you have to verify the download. In this case, I already did this before, so I will directly be redirected to the download page, and this is a page where I can click on this download button and where I will then download the TradeBuddy. So let us wait a second. I can already check the downloads folder where it is stored by default. So I think this is the file. Okay, let me take the file and move it. Oh, okay, now it is open already. Let me move it to the desktop, and I can close the web browser now. So this is the TradeBuddy.zip file that you will download. I can then right click and extract it here to the desktop. And if I did it like this, I can now see there are several files inside. And for example, the first file is the TradeBuddy.exe file, which is the executable, of course. I can click on it, and there is a warning that this the publisher of this app is not known to the PC. Yeah, I mean, this is okay because I published the app, so there's no virus inside or anything. And if you click on OK, you will then open this TradeBuddy software. It is kind of empty right now because there are no trades inside, but we can now start adding trades. And since this is for the English-speaking community, before you want to do anything, you want to click on Menu and then Einstellung, which is the German word for settings, and there you can choose another language. Here, you can click on this drop-down, you can switch to English, and you can click on Bestätigen, which is Apply. And then the language was changed, and you can restart the program, and then you will see that now everything is written in English. So, and in this TradeBuddy directory, or in any directory, maybe even on the desktop, where you start the TradeBuddy.exe file, there will be a app-trade-buddy.db file created. This is the database file, and this is the file where all the data is stored in. So if you delete this, the TradeBuddy will have to start all over again, pretty much. So it will be empty. So make sure that you do not delete it, and that you will always have this file in the same folder as you have the TradeBuddy.exe file. Okay, so let us have a look at this program now. We can now start adding new trades. For example, we can right-click and say new trade, and then we can say that we want to add a trade. For example, this trade has a ID, and it has a strategy and a symbol and a lot size and a entry somewhere. I mean, this is just fictional data, and I can confirm this. But as you saw already, we cannot add a strategy or a symbol. This is because, first of all, we have to provide data for this. So we click on data and on strategies and symbols. And there we can start adding symbols like euro, US dollar, We can add this. We can say US dollar, Japanese yen, for example. We can add this. And you can now see both of these are added to a program already. And I can also add strategies. I mean, you can choose the names that you use for your strategies. But if we did this, and if we now double click our trade that we have here, we can now see that we are able to provide a symbol and a strategy. And if I confirm this, you can see that this is automatically added to the strategy and symbol window here. So let me add maybe some more strategies that I use, the Donkian channel system and the SIR record system, because we will use this later on. So what else can I tell you? Okay, so of course you can fill in more information. Make sure that if you fill in a entry and exit time, that you keep this format, which is the year, then the month and the day, and afterwards the time of the position opening or closing. And this will only be accepted if you fill in the right format. Then you can, of course, provide commission, an exit price, and so on. And, of course, a profit for this trade, which was, for example, 22 euro or dollar or whatever your account is based on. Okay, if we did this now, we have a new trade. So this is kind of time-consuming, and this is the process that you will have to deal with in any or pretty much any trading journal. So there is a much more easier way of doing so. So let me demonstrate this. I can, of course, right-click this and delete this trade. So we have an empty program again. And what I will do now is I will open the MetaTrader 5. And in this MetaTrader 5, all the historical trades are already documented in the history. So we can use this history and export the trades from here and import them into our into a trade buddy. So how can we do this? Remember, we have the folder that we downloaded, and there are some files inside. For example, this trade buddy mt5.ex5 file, and I can simply copy this because this is a script. And I will switch back to the MetaTrader 5, and I click on File, Open Data Folder. And please make sure that you copy these exact steps here. And then I click on MQL5. I click on scripts, and then I paste this file here. You see, now we have the tradebuddy.mt5 file here. I can now close this folder, and I can click in the navigator in my MetaTrader 5. If you do not see it, you can click on View Navigator. And there I can click on scripts. By the way, the process is exactly the same with the MetaTrader 4. Then I can click on refresh, and you can see the TradeBuddy MT5 file is here. Now I can double click it, and I can see the inputs here. Oh, and this is still in German, by the way, so maybe I will have a translation already if you download this program. So here I can choose the time period that I want to export. So for example, if I choose Gesamt, this is the total history. So if I click on OK, you can see there is an alert, and it says that I exported 1,346 trades, and the file is stored at this specific location. So if you want to export the whole history, you can do it like this. So I can now follow this path. Or I choose an easier way, which is I click on File, Open Data Folder, MQL5, Files, and there you can find the tradingtagebuch.txt or whatever it is called. Maybe I can call it tradebuddy.txt. Yeah, but you take this file and you copy it, and I will just put it on my desktop. So put it on my desktop. It is not moved to my desktop, so let me do it like this. Okay, so we have the tradingtagebuch.txt file here, and let's go back to the trade buddy, and I can now click on data, MT4 or MT5 import, and I can search for this file. So on the desktop, I can double click it, and it will now load all the trades from this file directly into the trade body. You can see this may take a while, depending on how many trades you loaded. And now you can see all the trades are now stored inside of the trade body with a symbol, with all the necessary information that we can already receive from the MetaTrader. So you can see everything is taken care of pretty much. And you can see now the trade body is able to calculate all the key figures and show a graph of the performance of this of these trades. So you can see this is super, super easy. And what I want to do now is I want to delete this app -trade.body.db. So I can reset my trade body to default pretty much. And now I want to include or import the trades from this tradebody.txt file, which is already in your tradebody folder that you downloaded from the website. This is a sample file pretty much. This is data from a live trading account of mine. And you can use this data to get used to the tradebody. So let's open the tradebody again. And what I want to do now is, of course, first of all, I want to change the language again, because if I delete the database file, all the settings are also deleted, like, for example, the language settings. So let's open the tradebody again. And what I want to do now is I want to click on data, MT4, MT5, import, and I want to find this trade tradebody or trading target boot.txt sample file from the folder that you download from the website. So, and if this error occurs, this is a problem, which might occur if you want to import or delete a lot of trades. Then you can simply restart the trade body and do the same thing again. So data, MT4, MT5 import, and import the same file. If you import a file multiple times, it will only import the trades that are currently not inside of the trade body. So it is no problem to include the same trades several times. It will not add them again, but it will simply add the trades that are not inside of the trade body yet. So this error is some problem with the database. I tried to fix it in the code, but I didn't really find a good solution. So just take this workaround and close and restart the program. This is, the trade body is a side project of mine. I do not make any money on it. So it is hard for me to like invest all my time into it. So just, use this little workaround if you experience an error like this. So what we did now is we included all the trades from the sample file, and this is now live trading data, so it looks a little bit more realistic. And you can see now you get all the information about this trading account. So for example, you get the information about the profit factor, the amount of trade, the drawdown, the hit rates of long and short trades. So this is super, super useful. And of course, I'm still able to modify the trades. I mean, I do not really see reasons for doing so, because most of the informations are already imported from the MetaTrader, but there are like some fields that cannot be taken from the MetaTrader, like the risk-reward ratio or the realized risk-reward ratio. If these key figures are important for you, you might fill them in here. But I just leave them blank. This were some requests from the German-speaking community. But of course, you do not have to fill these values. So what we can do now is we can, again, add some strategies here, like the open range breakout, the RTS system. These are the strategies that I use in this account, Donkian Channel System and a SIS strategy. And since I added them now, I can now filter all these trades. And this is super, super cool, because I can now go ahead and say, for example, I only want to filter the trades from year 2019. So I can do it like this. 19. And if I click on filter, you can see I will now only see the trades from 2019 here. So let me go to the bottom here. Okay, this didn't work. I think I had the wrong format. It has to be like this. So if I filter now, you can see I only get 1,090 trades, and these are only the trades in 2019. I can, of course, also see the graph And 2019 was a year where this account did not make any profit. So you can see everything because you are able to filter everything. And I can just reset this. Oh, and I can, of course, filter the starting time and the end time of a trade pretty much inside of every single day. So I can say I only want to have the trades from 9 o'clock until 12 o'clock or whatever. And I can, of course, always filter buy or sell trades. For example, like this, you can see this will only filter the buy or sell trades. And this is cool, but what is most important for me is filtering strategies. So since I added these strategies here in the symbol strategies window, I can now say, for example, I only want to have the open range breakout trades. So if I only choose this and click on filter, you see there are no trades filtered. And this is because I added the symbols and strategies here, but if we, let me reset the filter. If we have a look at our trades, there are no strategies inside. Because right now we only have the data that comes from the MetaTrader 5. And the MetaTrader 5 cannot know what strategy we used for a simple trade. So what my solution for this is, whenever I make a trade in the MetaTrader, I provide a comment like open range breakout and a magic number. And you can see, for every strategy that I use, there's a different magic number and a different comment. So what I can do now is I click on data, update strategies, and I can say, for example, search for all the comments that have ORB inside of the text. And then I want to apply the open range breakout strategy to all these trades. So if I click on update, you can see now the strategy input here is correct for all the trades that have ORB as a comment. And same can be done, of course, for other strategies or for other texts in the comment. So for example, the Donkin channel system, the RTS system, I can just update everything here with just some clicks. So this takes away a lot of effort and work. So now I filled in all the strategies with like 10 clicks for every trade. And I can now go back to my, not to my settings, but to my filter. And I can say, for example, I only want to have the ORB trades now. And if I click on filter now, you can see all the other trades are removed. And I only get the graph and the key figures for this specific strategy. Same can be done, of course, for other strategies, like the ATR strategy or the Donkin channel strategy. And I can, of course, also go ahead and say, I want to have the ORB strategy and I also want to trade symbols. So let me add some symbols here. Euro-US dollar, for example, US dollar, Japanese yen. These are the symbols where I use the ORB strategy. So let me filter, for example, only the Euro-US dollar trades. So in total, we have 3,018 trades for Euro-US dollar and US dollar, Japanese yen. But if I only filter the Euro-US dollar, I get, of course, less trades. And if I, for example, filter the US dollar, Japanese yen trades only, I get new key figures and a new graph. So I'm able to filter pretty much all the strategies for all the symbols. And I can also, if I do not have any strategies here, I can also filter the magic numbers. So if I do it like this, I do not filter any trades because I did not select anything. But if I say I only want to select magic number one, I can add magic number one here. Oh, and it should filter the magic number one. Oh, I think it is because of the symbols. I have to accept all the symbols here. And now filter again. And only the magic number one is selected. And I can say I want to have magic number one and magic number three, for example. So if we do it like this, I get magic number one and three. And I can do the same for the comment. I want to have all the trades that, for example, have ORB in the comment section. Or all the trades that have SL, for example, in the comment section. And this is, of course, not really profitable because I only have the SL trades or the TP trades. But I think you get the idea of this. And what we can also do to get like more realistic data here, for example, for the drawdown in percent, we can go to File, Settings, and we can set the starting balance, which was 1,200 for this account, and now the maximum drawdown is calculated correctly. So this is pretty much what you can do with this Trade Buddy. So yeah, I explained filter, I explained settings, I explained data. Oh, and I think there's only one thing left here at the data menu. So there's the accounts option. If I click on it, I can have access to all my accounts here. The default account is account 0.1, but of course you may have a different account number in your MetaTrader, so you maybe want to rename it to, like, I don't know, the account number of your account in the MetaTrader. So I can rename it, and you can see all the trades are automatically also renamed for the account property here. And you can also see the currently selected account in the upper left corner. I can also go ahead and, for example, create more accounts. If I do it like this, I can say create account, and I now have another account. And I can switch accounts here. For example, I go to this just created account, click on select account, and you can see there are no trades in this account, of course, because I did not add any trades here. But I can say, for example, I want to add some trades here, or I can import trades, I can confirm, and I can also always switch around between these two accounts. So this account holds all the trades from my live trading account. This account holds all the trades, or the one trade that I just added. And I can also go ahead and, for example, say I want to select the main account, and then I want to delete the other account here. Please make sure that you do not delete the main account, and this should be should not be allowed by the program. Hope there is no error. So if I can delete this account, it is now gone, and I only have one account left. So I can select, rename, and create accounts here. So this is pretty much it about the Trade Buddy. Yeah, make sure to leave me some feedbacks to this about this program. What functionalities do you like? What functionalities do you miss? And yeah, make sure to give me some feedback on this. And I hope that you can use this program and that you have fun and that it makes your life much more easier.